It's Thursday, 7th of February, and out here at Sue's place in Yass, doing the final preparations for our trip, which is going to last almost a week. We trial run for our bigger trip later in the year out to Central Australia and Northern Territory. So we're going to be testing, you know, what we're going to take away on that trip this time around, and we're heading down to Victoria through Namadgi and down through Blue Water Holes and then down the Barry Way and then finally up to Wadbilliga National Park in New South Wales, and also the Deua River National Park, I think, but Sue's got all that in hand, so I'll just be following along. It's probably, it's 9:42, and we just have to pack away the solar panel. It's charging the battery, which is powering the fridge. So all our food, refrigerated food, each vehicle, we've got Sue's vehicle over there and then their other vehicle, which Steve and myself will be taking on our Northern Territory trip. So I'll pack up now and we'll be heading off shortly. Time is 10:31 and first stop is at the Tamar Bridge, where the road crosses the Murrumbidgee River as it enters Burrinjuck Dam. Water levels very low.
Mountain trails.
Okay, opening right up.
Yeah.
Fire danger today, very high.
Well, we won't be having it.
Well, yeah, well, over what the Canberra has.
I forgot to push the thing in. So what about David?
It's 10 to 12 and we're on the Webbs Ridge Road in the Brindabella National Park. Stopped to let a bit of air out of the tyres. Was getting a bit rocky. The light should come on when it's recording.
Okay.
Time is 12:27 and just stopped off the road for lunch. A few teething problems, seems leaking water at somewhere in the back of the van. We've identified where the water's leaking. Looks like a poor joint, braised joint or cracked. So try and put some tape around, otherwise not much else we can do at this place. Three lengths of the silicone tape seems to have done the job and certainly slowed down the drip, maybe stopped it completely. We'll know after lunch. The value of having this shakedown trip is certainly proving itself. Got an electrical problem now with the fridge powered from the car. When we pulled up here, it wasn't working. Just have to sort that one out now. It seems the Anderson connector powering the fridge is not working. Yeah, it seems no power from the vehicle. So, not sure what that is. Not much we can do, I don't think. We'll power the fridge off the battery, which is in the back of the van.
What watching his car go down.
Well, according to Sue's HEMA map, we've got about 5 kilometres left to Flea Creek where we're camping tonight.
There's camp there, and we're here.
The road's been a bit rocky and steep in places, and we've tried a number of times to get the vehicle into low range, but haven't been successful yet. So we're just soldiering along in four-wheel drive, high range. Well, Philip's got the magic touch. He's been able to get the vehicle into low range straight off. Come to an intersection that's not shown on the map and it's got us a bit confused. We're having to study the map. We think we turn left and head up the hill before going back down again. Okay, well, Philip's safely made it down. We're just perched on top of this really steep descent. We've just put it into low range and we're on the into first gear, so we'll take our time and hope we get down the bottom and join Philip.
A little bit that's really steep.
Thanks, Philip.
Thank you. There's a couple of washouts there. This is rougher than the track we took Dad on.
This mogul makes it look stupid too.
Yeah. You get these going into Deua.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you don't know where the road is. Bit of a roller coaster. Certainly steep.
Leaned up on the dash.
Nah.
Didn't I close my eyes as well?
Yeah, David's got his shut.
Almost.
We made it.
Well done.
Thank God for first gear.
The low range helps a lot too.
Yes.
It cuts you right back.
Lost Philip.
I wonder it's called what? Webb's Ridge.
Yeah.
There's Philip. Yep, a hairpin. Shouldn't be any caravans here anyway.
No.
creek's a bit dry. Kangaroos.
Kangaroo, first one I've seen all day.
Yeah, David just spotted him. Have you seen any goannas yet?
No goannas, no.
Will we just pick a spot then to camp?
I think it's up along here somewhere, isn't it?
Well, anywhere takes your fancy.
Anywhere flat.
Time's 5 p.m. and tents are up, just started to rain, and we've moved the other car to deploy its awning to give a bit more protection. But rain hasn't lasted very long, and after about 5 minutes it stopped again. Cheers!
To camping! Cheers.
Successful day.
Yeah, good day.
No, David, you went really well. It's life? Yep. David had his first day four-wheel driving, really, and I think he was thrown in the deep end with a couple of the hills. What do you reckon?
Yeah, they weren't that easy, they weren't that long, but they were pretty rough and pretty steep, some of them. Yeah, I thought it was good.
After we had to play around and try and get it into low range, and Philip had to come and help us, but hopefully we'll get better at that. Yeah.
Yes.
How did you feel?
Move it from the rain. Yes, certainly some of those hills were steep and you had the moguls. You know, so if you don't know what's in front of you because you're pointing up towards the sky and the... the roads dropping down way below you.
Yeah.
I mean, you go over the mogul and then all comes into view again, and it's a bit rocky, and you know, we had to let some air out of the tyres. And yeah, so tomorrow it's not too far to the Piccadilly Circus, Brindabella Road, and then we'll be heading down to Blue Water Holes and
down some fire trails.
But Sue's read out the warning that it's the first section tomorrow's supposedly very
damaged track
and steep, and so we'll have our test tomorrow to get out of here.
Yep.
But just started to rain again, so tents are pitched.
Another car's come in and went back out the same way, so he must have thought he can go out. So if he can do it, we can.
Yes, yeah,
he
so.
He had a Prado.
That's right.
Yeah, so it was enjoyable. It's happy hour, and we'll have our dinner a bit later. I think Sue's cooked some casseroles.
Sausages in a casserole.
So.
Well, it's a happy hour with happy campers.
Yeah. So. That's about it for now, and then, yes.
Peanuts. There you go, you want that one? You can borrow it.
You can borrow.
Yeah. fried rice. I'll need it soon. And I think sausages in garlic and hoisin or something sauce from Aldi. Yum.
Yum, yeah.
Except I dripped it all
around. Time is 8:05 and it's the 8th of February. Little bit of rain in the early part of last night, but looks like going to be a nice day, at least in the morning. We've got the sun's up a while ago and waiting for it to clear the ridge behind us and over that way actually, but and then we should get a bit of sunshine here. Yeah, I've got the solar panel out and because we're still in the shade here, not doing that marvellously, about 4 watt, and the lead acid battery's been running the fridge since we left Yass, and this morning it was down to 12.4 volt. So since I've been up at 7 o'clock, I had it out connected to the panel, charging again, and the voltage is now up to 12.5. So we'll just do our chores at the camp and then we'll be off a bit later. Yeah. Time's 9:26 and we're all packed up. Just got the solar panel. It's now in full sun and pumping out 100 watts. So the fridge voltage now up to 13.4 volts. So we'll be packing up soon and leaving. Just having a cup of coffee. Just been down to the river, had a splash around in the shallow water. So everything going well. Time is 10 a.m. and disconnected the panel. Battery voltage now 12.7 volts.
Oh, well, that was a nice camping spot.
It's not very far to the Piccadilly Circus, Brindabella Road, but it's quite steep and I think, believe from what Sue's researched, more difficult than what was coming in from the other side yesterday. We got the vehicle into low range straight away by having it in neutral when the low range switch was selected.
I continued on Channel Annie Road, not the one that turns off to the right. I went to the straight ahead to the left.
Okay, thank you.
Bit washed out.
Yeah. Tyre tracks are up that way.
He's up there.
Yeah.
No through road lock gate.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
It's certainly washed out.
Yes.
You wouldn't be coming up here in the Corolla?
Oh no. Definitely not. This goes on and on. I suppose we were fairly high on the other side. I think we're getting near the top. A lot more washed out on this side. Steep drop on either side of us. Still climbing.
Oh, it's steep too.
What's this road?
Time is 10:43 and we're at the main road now. Just removed it out of low range. It works much better if you put into neutral and went straight off. So it's now going to be a sort of a two-wheel drive accessible road until we turn off to go down the fire trails down towards Blue Waterholes. Back in the 1980s, when I first came to Canberra, the road, now called Crace Lane, was open to traffic. I think back then it was called Long Plain Road. From my understanding, the access rights was a bit ambiguous, and then I think one of the properties changed hands and the new owner decided to close the road and put a lock gate. So that's what's happened, and no longer can get access now through to Long Plain. We'll have to go further towards Tumut before we turn off and go to get down to Long Plain.
Bondo State Forest.
Coming up soon, I'll know when I get there probably.
The road seems quite wet.
Yeah. They probably had rain last night too.
Definitely out of the state forest. Must be, you know, it looks like a low-budget road.
Low-budget anyway.
I thought last time the bushes were closer into our vehicles.
I think they've come a little bit later.
More water.
Definitely had more rain here too.
Yeah, we're just watching you go through the mud. Getting more water.
Yeah, it's a little bit deeper than what it might appear too, but it's not too bad. Yep.
Drop down on the left a little bit.
Winding now, so that'll get us away from the water.
Yeah, hopefully. There's a bit of water down there.
Must have been stuck in there.
You reckon someone's got stuck?
Yeah, all the sticks are there, side by side.
We'll just go where you went.
Well, since this road's seen a grader.
Yeah, it probably doesn't see a grader. Seems a lot rougher than I remember it.
Yeah, I think it is just a little bit. It's just that little bit wet, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever seen a road in Australia this wet. You don't have much choice. The car just goes where it wants to go.
Yeah, feed on dry land here anyway. I remember that bit of rubber.
We'll wash some of the mud off.
I remember that bit of rubber. Big lot of horse manure there.
Further.
No, we'll have lunch here, I think, because it might take us a while yet.
Time is 12:30 and just pulled up to have lunch. Deployed the solar panel. Before we connected up the panel, the voltage on the battery was 12.5 volt. solar panel producing 97 watt.
Blackberries are growing out onto it. Debris on the track at times. We turn right here.
Time is 3:45 and we're camped at Magpie Flat camping ground, not far from Blue Water Holes. Just got here in time before it started to rain, and while putting up the awning, it partially collapsed and one of the aluminium spars hit Sue on the arm and a lot of blood. So Phil's working on the arm, and while we set out this rain, and then we can get the other awning out and start thinking about dinner.
Hey, it's getting wet out there.
How's your arm, Sue?
Well, it's all covered up. It's a bit sore, but it'll be okay, I hope.
It'll be sore tomorrow. Yeah, definitely sore tomorrow.
This vehicle has the solar panel on the roof of the rear section, and although it has been sunny today, the battery not quite fully charged as it was when we pulled into camp yesterday. The other battery powering my Aldi fridge is down to 12.4 volts. It hasn't had nearly enough opportunity to charge today, only a little bit before we left Flea Creek this morning, and then not even half an hour at lunchtime. Time is 7 a.m. and we're up and about. Heard some horses wandering through the campsite last night and also some dingoes howling around 5:30 this morning. I've got the solar panel out now. Just before connecting the panel up to the battery was showing 12.3 volts. Obviously fridge is in its dormant mode. The Zoom H1N giving problems. When I go to record a file, it says cannot create file. I've tried putting a 64 gigabyte memory card into the Zoom. That's the smallest that I've got, but it says invalid card. I think I need a 32 gigabyte or less, which I don't have. So no more Zoom until I can get to Woolworths or something and buy a replacement 32 gigabyte card. Squinting, you know, because sun's bright, getting 100 watts now from the panel, and it's 6.6 amps into the battery, so that should be good if it stays like this. We can charge up the battery a bit. Well, we've just had a bit of a discussion about our plan, so it seems after we wait here for a little while the batteries charge, we'll head down to the Snowy Mountains Highway and turn right, and then there's a track that starts somewhere over towards Talbingo Way, and then that'll loop round the back of Yarringabilly Caves and comes out near Mount Selwyn. So it's a dirt track, that's all I know, so we'll know, find out more when we get there. And then tonight we're supposed to be camping somewhere around at Three Mile Dam, I think. We'll perhaps go to Jindabyne and down to the Barry Way to Jacobs River camp area. So just see how things go with time, and then we'll go around the snowy down the Barry Way down to and cross it at MacKillop's Bridge, and then from there to Wadbilliga, and two nights in Deua, and should be back in Yass on Thursday. Time's 9:35 and we'll just pack up now. So far on this trip, the solar panels collected 269 watt hours of energy, and the fridge has taken 373 watt hours. So it's still in deficit, but it's catching up. Just taking a detour on the Port Phillip Trail. Sign says that the causeway through the dam is closed. Was open 2 years ago when I went through, but temperature outside is about 14 degrees, a bit nippy in the wind.
Must be fairly used to cars if they got them on the road. charging our battery much today, I don't think.
Time is 1:15 and stopped beside the road for lunch. Got the solar panel out in full sun. It's getting about 125 watt. The meter on the panel showing that it's collected since Yass 340 watt hour, and the monitor on the battery showing that it's taken 390 watt hour from the battery to power the fridge. Solar panels catching up.
What's that bigger up there?
It's the Yarringabilly River. Just to break up, so let's go.
See if we can find a nice spot to camp. Thank you.
And very windy, a bit chilly, not really expecting this cold weather for February.
It's 10th of February, wind dropped during the night and clear sky in the morning, frost, temperature about -1 degree Celsius, a lot of mist coming up off the lake in the early morning. Sue's fridge is down to 2 bar and the Aldi fridge's batteries was 12.3 volts this morning. In full sun, the solar panel's producing 105 watts at about 19 volts. The charge current into the battery is 6.8 amps. So far, the fridge has taken 460 watt hour out of the battery. The minimum battery voltage is 11.6 volts. Now, solar panel has collected 368 watt hour. Time's 9:41 and still at Three Mile Dam. The solar panel's now collected more energy than what the fridge has drawn out of the battery. Don't know what the efficiency loss in the conversion is. I'll know that once the battery gets to full charge. Not a cloud in the sky, perfect blue sky. The solar panel's collected 485 watt hour. The fridge not drawing much now because of the cold temperature in the environment. The fridge has taken 461 watt hours out of the battery at this point of time, and currently the PowerTech controller's putting 6.8 amps into the battery.
Off walls, so I don't know what they're doing.
No.
No.
I've been there, but I can't remember. It's 6.
It wouldn't take 2 meters.
2 meters of snow in his backyard. Sue Gatling. sleeps there in the sun.
Time is 1:10 and stopped here for lunch in Jindabyne. Just been to the Pie Cafe and got nice big serve of fish and chips, flathead, a lot of chips, and be heading nice. Comment, Sue's been commenting about how nice it is in the sun, having survived the frost at Fremantle Dam. From here, we'll be heading to Woolworths to get a few more provisions and fill up the car, which is the car that I've been driving's down just over half a tank now. And then we'll be heading down the Barry Way and probably camp tonight at Jacobs River. While we were in Jindabyne, I got another 16 gigabit memory card from Woolworths, and I've just put it in the Zoom recorder and it's recording again. All I can think of is that the file structure of the previous memory card is corrupted. Not sure whether what I've recorded on there is accessible or not. Won't know until I get home.
Oh my gosh, they're doing well, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
Time's 3:00 and we're here at Wallace Craigie Lookout. He was the editor of local paper that campaigned in the 1800s to have this road built. Maybe it's one of the first roads through to Victoria in this area. It's all dirt, probably till where we turn off to go to MacKillop's. And we've just got to go down the bottom of this hill, and the first campground we come to is Jacobs River, which is where Nisha and I camped it's probably 18 months ago now, maybe a bit less. But that's a smaller river which flows into the Snowy, and where you pitch the tent is right beside the river, whereas the other campgrounds, I think you're further away from the river, nearer the road. The road's not quite near the river. So I think it's quite a pretty location, Jacobs River. And have to be wary tonight of the possums, which are quite aggressive. And they, last time when Nisha and I were here, they were jumping all over the table trying to eat our dinner while we were having it. So we'll head off now and should get to the campsite early and be able to get some charge into the batteries again, and then we'll have a nice happy hour.
better out here. It's sandy over here.
The thermal shocks have been out of the water too long. This is the life.
Yeah.
Time's 20 past five and solar panel's been out in the sun and we've had a swim down in the river. The solar panel's producing 17.4 volts and 96.8 watts. That's a current of about 5.5 amps measured at the solar panel. The energy collected is 672 watt hours since we've left Yass. At the battery end, the battery voltage is 13 volts and currently the fridge is running, drawing 4.06 amps from the battery. The minimum voltage the battery's reached is 11.6 volts. The energy drawn from the battery is 513 watt hour. Currently, the current from the panel into the battery measured at the battery is 6.4 amps. Well, the battery's now fully charged. It's on float now. It's about 700 watt hours from the panel.
Happy hour down at Jacobs River in the Kosciusko National Park.
A few little twigs, yeah, you can
boil water.
Well, the battery's now fully charged. It's on float now, and it's about 700 watt hours from the panel. So that's good. We're back to full charge. I'll just go check what the energy taken out of the battery.
So that's 523
watt hours taken by the fridge from the battery. So it's taken 700 watt hours from the sun to charge it back to full charge. It was full charge when we left Yass back on Thursday. Been good day for sun today, so got some sun before we left Three Mile Dam, and now we've had plenty of sun in the afternoon here at Jacobs River. So we'll have dinner now soon and then have a nice evening.
A thermal pot. I cooked this morning. It's spaghetti bolognese and it's been cooking in the car as we drove today. And now we're just boiling some pasta here and that will make our meal. So simple. Having a cup of tea.
Well, I can feel the warmth from here.
Yeah, I like good fires.
How's your fire, Sue?
Well, ask Philip. I'm a good pyromaniac. I like campfires.
Philip's a gatherer for the firewood.
Yep.
The gatherer and hunterer.
But what got it going was the straw, because it wasn't going before I put that straw on. But anyway, Philip, there you go. Your turn.
Yeah, there's no doubt about these kings. That's a genetic trait in them, being pyromaniacs, all right.
David started it with his little...
David's inspiration with his little cooker there. He got the fire going in that, and we had a smoking ceremony there with Welcome to Country and with the gum leaves, and it worked well. We feel very welcome here, and it's a beautiful spot to camp. lovely sitting in the river there earlier, and yeah, it's just very quiet, peaceful.
No one else around.
Yeah, and just the right number of campers here again. Yeah, just the three of us.
Yep.
25 degrees Celsius when we arrived, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I think it's still pretty much that.
25 degrees, and yeah, and what more can you ask for?
This time last night, I think it was about 7 degrees.
Something like that, and the howling wind.
And howling wind, and we gathered in our tent for an hour, huddled up till it was about 7:30, and we thought, well, bedtime.
I was wearing three layers.
But tonight, it's now what time?
Well, now I'm still in my shorts and T-shirt, which I went swimming, and they're just about dry now. But yeah.
And we've done your washing.
Done the washing and...
cooked our dinner before the possums attack us.
Yeah, we're still waiting to see if they turn up.
And, yeah, looking forward to a peaceful night and maybe a dip in the Jacobs River
tomorrow morning.
In the creek.
Yep.
And then...
before we follow the snowy river down heading for MacKillops.
I can't remember now. It's a bit past Slug and Buggin where you turn off.
Yeah, Slug and Buggin's where the old school is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep.
Down into Victoria.
Well, just into Victoria, isn't it? And then we're heading towards...
MacKillops
Bridge, and then onto Wadbilliga National Park.
So tomorrow being Monday, MacKillops, and Wadbilliga Tuesday, Deua Thursday. Oh, Wednesday, sorry.
Well, it depends. Yeah, if you want 2 nights in Deua, that way we can walk to the Bendrethan Caves.
Okay, so we can't stay at MacKillops, is it?
Hang on, what are we? Sunday.
We're on Sunday.
Monday, Tuesday. Yeah, so we've got to be home. Yeah, we can have Wednesday, Thursday in Deua.
Right.
Yep. We've got to be home.
Thursday.
Oh, Thursday. So... anyway, whatever it works out.
We'll camp somewhere.
That's a good part about camping. You camp where you want to.
Yeah.
Yeah, on a trip like this, it's pretty easy going, isn't it? It's just wherever we get to and...
Yep. Been easy driving today.
All on the road. All on the sealed road except for the last bit down to Jacobs River.
Only passed a couple of cars. On the dirt. Philip's in the lead, so he radios us ahead so we don't have to panic when we see someone come around a bend.
The camera again.
Is it still filming?
Yeah, yeah, just about, give that 20 seconds. Around 8 a.m, while Sue and I were busy packing stuff away, we heard a neigh, and when we looked up, we could see a horse at the end of the campground grazing on the grass. It stayed about 20 minutes, and then another one turned up, and then they both moved out of sight.
Time is 10 o'clock and at the border of New South Wales and Victoria, place is called Wills, and there's a memorial for the opening of the road on the 4th of May 1961.
Hello. We're sitting halfway between New South Wales and Victoria.
Right on the border.
Time is 12:33 and at the lookout overlooking Little River Gorge, the sign says this is the deepest gorge in Victoria. It has taken millions of years for Little River to create it by eroding away hundreds of metres of rock. The gorge is 4 kilometres long and up to 500 metres deep, while Gulmarang Creek plunges 300 metres from its partially hidden chasm in the gorge wall opposite the lookout.
Thank you.
time is 5 p.m. and we're at a campsite near the Delegate River. It's surrounded by forestry plantation where they're logging at present. This campsite's got a lot of tall trees and trying to get every little bit of sunlight to charge the battery. Phil's angle fridge battery's down to 3 bar and hasn't charged much during the day. It'll drop down overnight and we'll be going through Wadbilliga Park tomorrow. Not good opportunities there for charging. So they're running the fridge off their spare smaller battery at the moment. My panel producing at the moment about 30 watts with sun shining through top canopy of the trees. So the panel's collected to date so far 908 watt hour. The fridge has taken out 727 watt hour. At the moment, getting about 1.9 amps into the fridge battery.
Sausages and eggs tonight with vegetables. Here's Philip. And then we got veggies. Not bad campsite. Quiet.
Most of the time, except when truck goes past.
Looks like this spot. Well, pancakes. Eating well on this trip.
Okay, lid on.
Time is 8:10 and just a few final checks before we leave Delegate River camping area and we'll head into Bendock and then on to Wadbilliga. Time is 9:10 and at the top of Delegate Hill. Altitude is 1,300 metres. Bit cool up here with a strong breeze blowing. Time is 12:56 and we're at the entrance into the Wadbilliga National Park. stopped to let the tyres down, got 33 PSI on the front and 34 on the rear. After lunch, we'll go through this big puddle on the road and continue on. Sue doesn't think we'll reach Deua National Park today, so we'll probably be camping somewhere along the way.
We're going good, we're just going up a bit of a hill.
Real rough, rocky one.
Yes, I remember it from last time. Yep, we're doing well here. Track's getting narrower too, isn't it? The track is getting narrower as well.
Yeah, I didn't think it was quite overgrown like that before, but maybe it was.
Yeah, can't really remember.
Range second gear.
We've just encountered this fallen branch blocking the road, so I have to get the chainsaw out to clear the blockage. Phil quickly clears the blockage with his chainsaw and we're on our way again. Time's 2:28 and I've made the suggestion to Sue and Phil that we camp here beside Wadbilliga River. Seemed to me the best place. We can get good access to the sun now to charge the batteries for the fridges, and nice river, could even have a swim. The other campsite's about 4 kilometres further down the road, and according to Sue and Phil, who've been there before, it's right amongst the trees and not good access to the sun. And water in this pool's very deep. Certainly can't stand. Water in this pool's very deep. Certainly can't stand. It's the 13th of February and it's rained a little bit overnight. Not raining now at 6:50 a.m. The fridge in Phil's vehicle has gone flat overnight. The fridge battery in my vehicle is down to 12.3 volts this morning. At the moment, pretty cloudy overhead. Sue's spare battery has got 3 bars lit. All packed up and ready to leave. We've done a bit of reorganising of the stuff in the fridges. I've now connected my fridge to run off the 12 volt supply of the vehicle. We've transferred some of the stuff from Sue's fridge into my fridge and vice versa. My battery's down to 12.3 volts, but now has no load.
David, he'll get the saw. Hmm? He's got the saw out.
out.
Time is 10:15 and stopped at the Yowrie River for morning tea, taking the opportunity to charge the battery at the moment from the solar panel, getting 7.6 amps into the battery from the strong sun. Sign says Wadbilliga National Park, 5 kilometres, that's where we've come from. Energy collected so far from the solar panel is 1,108. Time is 12:26 and we've reached the Churros River. Phil's already scouted out the river. Looks like it's a bit over knee deep at its deepest. We'll cross after lunch. I've got the solar panel out. It was producing 123 watts. Nice sun down here beside the river. That is 8.3 amps into the battery.
Did you? I would definitely then.
That's the deepest bit just there.
Okay.
Walking upstream, yeah, it's not that easy. Thank you.
Phil's just been on the radio saying that the bit of a problem ahead. They're logging down beneath us, and I think the road may be blocked. So it looks like we might have to turn around on this. We'll see what happens.
All been resolved. Phil's spoken to the forestry workers on the radio, and we can come through.
Time is 3:23, and at the Hanging Mountain lookout, you can see right over to the coast in the distance, a bit hazy. Not permitted.
Yep. Dampier Mountain Fire Trail.
Too bad you're there.
Yeah, it's just the first bit, I think. It was quite steep, and then...
Time is 20 past five, and all set up now at Bendefra Camping Ground. Bit overcast, not good for charging the fridge at the moment. Fridge has been running off the car supply all day, so the batteries had it easy, and currently 12.5 volts. The little battery is now powering Sue's fridge, and it's charged from 3 bar to 4 bar during the whole day, running off the inverter in the dual cab vehicle. The large battery of Sue's is flat. Well, this is our final camp on this, well, it's about 8 day long trip down into Victoria, and we're at Bendefra Camping Ground beside the Deua River. This is our Sue's got the campfire lit in preparation for a damper that she's going to cook a bit later on. And been a long day of driving today, with all on dirt road basically, almost, and it was quite steep coming down into Bendefra, and judging by the sign, it'll be even steeper tomorrow. Trailers are not allowed on the road that we'll be following out of here, which is a Dampier Fire Trail. Very nice camping ground here, nice big green grassy spot where we're camped, and we're the only people here. People have been here earlier, but they've left. Very nice spot. And how have you found it, Sue?
Oh, I found it pretty interesting. We had a few hiccups on the way. What was it? We came across a few trees that had to be moved manually, a couple with chainsaw, nothing too big, which was lucky. We also came across a closed sign for the logging. Philip got on the two-way and spoke to the fellas, and they said we could come down to a certain point, but they thought we were crazy going through the way we came. But we did it, we got through, and we're here and we're enjoying happy hour while I'm mixing a damper ready for sweets tonight.
How have you found it, Phil?
Oh, it's been interesting. We travelled, drove for about 5-6 hours, probably about 6 hours today, and we've done about 120, 130 kilometres. So it's been either up or it's been down. There's no flat country in round through here.
No.
Which is good, makes it all interesting, and the trails are good. You see a fair bit of scrub, I suppose, but it's...
Views are limited, other than trees.
Yeah, but yeah, it was quite good. Yeah, I seen a fox on the way down, a few kangaroos, a few wallabies, a lyrebird. Yeah, and coming down through Yowrie and what was the other place? Anyway, Yowrie, beautiful place. Every time I've been through there, it's just been immaculate,
heaven.
Just incredible.
Yeah, we spoke to some guy who said that up until a month or so ago, it was really brown, but it's been raining ever since, so... It's now greened up considerably, and yes, and rivers, they've been quite deep, sort of certainly over knee deep. We've crossed two today. First of all was the Churros and the Deua, but you know, the two vehicles, no problem.
Yeah, they were reasonably deep. They were up to my knees, so that was up to the top of the rim on the tyres, which was... Yeah, that's deep enough for us, I reckon, but
yeah.
Anyway, it was all good. It was a nice drive. We never got lost. Not that we know of, anyway.
Well, we've ticked a lot of boxes, I think, for David for his first outing, really, on four-wheel driving.
Not in the way of axle-deep mud, though.
We'll try to avoid the mud, but yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but no, David's done really well.
We're looking forward to an interesting drive out tomorrow. Last time we done it, it is reasonably steep, and it was quite rocky and a little bit rough, and so it'll be interesting too. But we've done it before, so I'm sure we can do it again without any trouble.
The only real hiccup I found, or you found, is our fridge still running.
Yes.
It's not charging as it should while we're driving.
No, it's not.
The fridge should be running off the... what do you call that thing?
Off the red arc.
Red arc at the front of the car.
Yes, well, that's been the problem, in that the vehicle supply to the fridge has not been working at all on this trip, and they've been relying on the solar panel on the roof, and that seems to be showing that it's charging, but twice now the fridge has run empty. Mm. Oh, sorry, the battery's run empty, so...
Yeah.
Something wrong there, but I'm sure an electrician can sort out why the vehicle supply is not getting back to the fridge. But once that's sorted out, then that'd be the biggest hurdle overcome.
Well, the other thing is we need to get solar panels probably fitted onto the second vehicle like we have, so when we pull up...
Well, ours is not a great advertisement, though, is it? We've been driving through the timber, though, and we haven't been getting a lot of sun on it. And when we have been out of it, it's been a little bit cloudy, so that's been restricting the charge through the solar panels.
They were charging just before I came over here, so...
They were, yeah.
Yep.
Yes, that's been the problem, that... because I've got to put my solar panel out on the ground to charge the battery, so that means the vehicle has to be stationary. So the only opportunity I get to charge is, you know, a bit before we leave, and then in the morning, then morning tea, and then bit at lunch.
Charging well though, and keeping up.
Yeah, the charges well when it you get the sun, and yeah. So, but I ran into my biggest problem at the beginning when we were getting the rain in the evening. In the afternoon, so when we pulled up, there was no good solar conditions for charging anyway. But the last few days have been good, and but yeah, you know, getting Sue wants to get on the way early, so I've decided that I'd run the fridge off the car supply today and save the battery to run it tonight off the battery.
And that worked okay?
Mm. Yep. Been going good. We're getting about 13.5 volts from the cigarette lighter. I don't know if that's enough to charge a battery. I don't know how it's supposed to charge that little battery of Phil's, but it went from 3 bar to 4 bar.
It's. I think the guy said to us that you shouldn't charge the battery off the car, isn't it? We'll be running, hopefully, the fridge off the car when we're driving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the big one.
And then the solar panels will be working to charge the battery.
Yeah, well, that's... Yeah, I'd like to thank Sue and Phil for inviting me out on this trip, and it's been a great experience. All my bushwalking has been in the lightweight arena, so... This is a new experience for me, the camp chairs and the tables and the happy hours and the camp ovens. It's sort of something that when you sort of got to lug everything along on your own shoulders that you tend to miss out on. But with the vehicles, you can virtually bring your house with you but
we're still restricted.
We don't do it very tough at all.
But we still are restricted how much we can carry. Yeah. We are underweight, which is great with this new setup, which I was happy with when we left town. Yeah.
Oh, well, that's about it. That we can we'll sign off now, and we'll get down to enjoying dinner, which will be the leftovers from...
It's fresh cooked.
Oh, no, sorry, I've mixed...
Beef cooked in the thermal
pot. Sue cooked it this morning before we left camp at... where were we? At Wadbilliga.
Yeah,
so I'd forgotten that. Yeah.
Just got to cook some pasta.
Just has to cook the pasta and put this damper on.
In the damper. I'm putting the pasta on now. You can't see it yet.
Time is 9 o'clock and we've all piled into the one vehicle and driven up to the car park for the walking track up to Bendefra Caves. The sign's saying that it's an 8 kilometre walk return. It's supposed to take about 2.5 hours. We won't be doing it on this occasion, so we'll just go back to the campsite and finish packing up, have morning tea, and then continue on back to Yass. This is Con Creek. The track out to the caves starts off following this creek before climbing steeply up the hill up to the caves. This is the grave site of James Richard George, one of the 15 children raised by Joseph and Mary George here at Bendefra. Like so many children of his era, James died in his infancy. Figures from major rural centres like Hill End at this time suggest children had a 1 in 5 chance of dying before they reached school age. Back at our campsite, I've had the solar panel out while we've been down at Bendefra Homestead Ruin. It's been in full sun with 7 amps going into the battery. The time's 9:44. So far, 1,344 watt hours collected the whole trip. The fridge has taken 1,226 watt hour. Wasn't connected to the battery, of course, yesterday. Energised coming up that slope, very rutted, wouldn't like to come up there in the wet, but did stop, which apparently no, but the car got going again. And we got time's 11:45 and we're at the trig point, which is at altitude 1239 metres. Been a bit steep and rocky ride coming up the hill from Bendefra, but I think the climbing's now behind us and we'll have lunch here and then continue on to the main road where we need to stop and reinflate the tyres again.
So what are we aiming for?